Good morning, everybody. Today is Monday. It's 8:10 a.m. Eastern Time, June 24. So let's start today. You know, just reviewing Bitcoin and the yields. The yields in general, but I highlight the 10-year yield. So back testing, you know, 7.73, when we went to all-time highs. You guys know that I closed all my crypto. Right, and I notify you guys that I'm done with the crypto, because in a graphic pattern, in a graphic perspective, you know, the cycle of cryptocurrencies supposed to be end, you know, this bull run, you know. And I have been explaining you guys several times why, you know, because the ETF came move to the Wall Street. Instead of create a ETN, they create a ETF. Now they provide liquidity to big players, billionaires, to get out. So as you guys have been seeing, you know, the ETFs have been in flow and the assets is still going down. Right, so I'm not bullish in crypto anymore. I saw a lot of people saying, oh, the United States will default, Europe will default, blah 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 blah. People will start to buy cryptocurrency. I don't think this will going to happen, because you know, the Wall Street now dominates the cryptocurrency, and now big players, big crypto billionaires, they have how can I say, they have liquidity to get out. Right, something that they didn't have before, because the Bitcoin was distributed in different, you know, exchange. Now basically, now all the Bitcoin is in Wall Street. Anyway, in Wall Street and with Michael Saylor. So the Bitcoin is being holded for 2-3 institutions. So it's not more decentralized as people, you know, think. Also, the mining companies, you know, is not is being paid off, because they're having. So the next having, they will receive 50% less than this current halving. You saw, you guys realize that this halving, you know, the we all time high before the halving, that was something that I expected, and I explain why. Why? Because this cycle is over. This bull run is over. Now, to make, you know, the miners being financial health, they need to increase the cost of the gas. The cost of, you know, to send and receive Bitcoin to one place to another. Otherwise, you know, these mining companies will not be survive. They will not receive the same amount as Bitcoin as before, right? So the tendency for me is to these items go low, 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 and make a stabilization some price. Maybe dies, but I cannot predict something. I only think that I predict you guys that this big cycle is over, and I expect now tops and bottom descendants. What I told you guys last week, I expect a back test at 57, 58, 800, then go back to 65, then a breakdown at 58,000, back test 52, then another melt up to 60, and then going back down to 45, and tops and bottom descendants. For me, this cycle is already over. Regarding the 10-year yield, the yields in general, I don't expect, you know, a meltdown in yields in general up before October this year, because we still have a lot of actions, and the biggest one will be on October, right? Especially if I'm not wrong, 20, 30, and 10 years. I already provide to you guys the calendar. So consequently, you know, makers, you guys have been seeing the huge demands in bonds, in US Treasury, especially in notes. So dealers, liquidity providers, makers, treasury banks, they are willing to buy cheaper, paying higher premium. I will explain this to you guys. I show you that S&P 500 is paying 1.15% with the big risk of a down in the face value. But in another hand, bonds are paying 4-5% 10 years, 20 years, with a big risk to see an increase in the face value. So where the premium is located? West Treasury, dollar. Dollar is king. Okay. I also highlight several times to you guys, don't be scared to see yields going down and DXY is going up. Pay attention that, you know, the DXY is inside in a channel and is still in uptrend. Why? Because the tendency of the money is come back to United States. So the dollar tend to increase in value compared with all other currencies, emerging markets, and also strong currency, yen, whatever, right? So the tendency is to see dollars going up and yields is going down, okay? Means we are entering a recession. As I said, I don't expect markets crashing this year. If it happens, you know, a majority of the people will be fucked up, right? Because you guys have been seeing, people have been creating theses to markets is eternally going up. And you guys have been seeing, you know, people is creating theses, say, oh, people is bearish. How people is bearish if people is are fully allocated? So, in regard to recession, if they declare a recession, I expect that they declare after October, as I told you guys. Why? Because the big bond actions. Okay? Since you already review, you know, the Bitcoin and yields and DXY, let's review the market structure documents and compare what we have in the book right now. So what I provide to you guys, the structure that they left in the book on Friday. So suggestion, first of all, the dark pool index and the GX. The GX showing us markets start to be in acceleration mode, but this is normal because, you know, the new flow will start to appear in the book on Wednesday. This bullish flow tends to end on Wednesday. So consequently, you see, you know, markets being accelerated. So the GX being dropped. In another hand, the bearish pattern, the DIX is also dropping. This is not good because, you know, market participant, big players not willing to buy in this at this level anymore. So the DIX start to drop. So liquidity providers is not providing liquidity anymore. Okay? They are removing liquidity from the book. Regarding, you know, the option book, what the levels are set up. 5,475 is the premium collection area and intended to be the resistance. 5,455 is the inflection point of the downside. 5,450 is the major support. We need to consider this a major support because the puts start to be in dominance. So if the dealers is now holding 5,450 puts, as soon as you break down 5,450 puts, they start to be exercised. Consequently, they will start to generate a lot of negative gamma, and consequently, markets tend to going down. To the sell pressure tend to appear. Okay, so 5,450 is the major support. The minor GX left on Friday is 5,430. So we tend to consider as a magnet. 5,465, 2 points above where we close, is the inflection point for the upside. As soon as you break 65, the tendency to go to 75. 5,440 could be the maximum downside target. Why? Because it's the second higher put volume strike and generate a lot of negative delta. So this tend to be the worst case scenario. If I'm wrong, if you go there and see a breakdown, I don't believe market breakdown of 25, because at 25 we start to see positive delta exposure in the book. Okay, per the gamma exposure, as I said, you know, magnet 5,430 is where located the negative gamma exposure. Remember that, you know, 2 weeks ago, I started to post in the Twitter and consequently told to you guys before that I expect the reverse of the trend start on Thursday, June 20, because two things. Because this big negative delta exposure above 5,500 and because the solstice, right? I expected, you know, a reversal in the trend start last third. So far, we are in the process. This biggest bullish flow ends on Wednesday. We will see a confirmation of a reversal this week after Wednesday, right? And since Tuesday, we have been seeing red days, right? Or at least sideways days. And major is because the negative delta flow that jumped in the book 2 weeks ago above 5,500. Okay? Anyway, let's compare what we have right now in the book. 5,475 is still the DX, is still the rejection area. So, could you be the maximum upside target? As you know, Friday suggests to us. If you break up 75, 95 tend to print. 5,495, as I put in the market structure document, could you be the maximum upside target for today? Note, per the delta exposure, we start to see weakness below 5,470. right? Below 5,470, stock market starts to show weakness. And at 5,435, that was the minus GX, you know, the delta starts to be positive, right? This is in process to be positive. Before, the minus GX was 5,430, and consequently, you know, the magnet. Pay attention in the GAM exposure after, you know, the CBOE update, you know, now 5,425 is the defense, exactly where we saw positive delta exposure on Friday. So the worst case scenario is 5,425, but I believe that 5,450 will tend to hold. Right, so we it's important to check out the levels. First one for the downside, 55, then 50, and then 40. Breaking down 40, expect 25. For the upside, 75, premium collection area, tend to be the rejection. If you see a breakup of 5,475, 5,495 tend to print, and you'll be the maximum upside target. Okay, remember the region that started at 85 and 90 before on Friday was the rejection. So after 75, you need to look for 85 and 90. And the last one, 95. Okay, so basically the levels are the same. The structure is the same. Could you also be a pump, a dump and pump? I don't disregard that. Because, you know, as soon as you saw Monday, in the last couple of the days, they have been set up, you know, a dump and pump. Because as I explained to you guys, you know, new money is not enjoying the party. So what they need to do to bring the market up? They need to bring market thrust down, generate, you know, negative delta exposure, generate negative gamma exposure. Because how is the pattern of the negative gamma? Sell weakness, buy rallies. To buy rallies, you know, they need to generate gamma squeeze. You know, print positive, huge delta flow in the book, generating, you know, enough gamma to squeeze up to where they want to go, right? This is what we have been seeing since last week. They are dumping pump through the gamma, through market structure, okay? Guys, take care. Pay attention to the levels. We don't have anything in economic data that could affect the market today. You know, the economic data so far is really calm. It's really calm. So pay attention in the levels, right? Pay attention in the levels and play accordingly. I know that the majorities have been creating theses to believe in something. And I'm a person that I don't believe in theses. I believe in flow. And I trade according to the flow. Fabio, are you bullish in any assets? Yes. I'm very bullish in US Treasury, especially in the notes, 10 plus years. Because I have been explaining to you guys the premium. We have a lot of premium, a lot of shorts in US Treasuries, and we have been seeing a lot of demand. As soon as you enter in a recession, you know, money flow back to United States. Money flow back to US dollar. Guys, take care and enjoy your day.